Once users have accessed your homepage or your application, you'll likely want the user to register for an account. But this isn't always the case. You should keep in mind that registration doesn't have to be the next immediate step in your process. You should think carefully about the entire user experience, the product you're offering, and when you want registration to happen, if you want registration to happen at all. Registration on Udacity's site is fairly simple, with just a couple fields, or you could also log in using Facebook or Google. For more detailed examples of signups and onboarding, check out useronboard.com, which is linked in the instructor notes. You can walk through examples, such as Gmail, to see all the design elements that guide first-time users. These details include animations, text annotations, tooltips, and calls to action. All of these lead the user to successfully using the product for the first time. Now, there are many ways to build out a successful onboarding experience, and our best piece of advice is to test your ideas with users using wireframes and mockups. We'll cover how you can do this with a design sprint in the next lesson. To get a real sense of why testing is important, check out this article about Yammer signup flow. The company found very counterintuitive results by adding just one step to the registration flow.